Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture video of System Software and Compilers Module 2. In this lecture, let us look at applications of compiler technology. Compiler technology has other important uses as well. Additionally, compiler design impacts several other areas of computer science. Here, let us see the most important instructions and applications of the technology. A high-level programming language defines a programming abstraction. The programmer expresses an algorithm using the language, and the compiler must translate that program to the target language. Generally, higher level programming languages are easier to program in, but are less efficient. That is, the target programs run more slowly. The programmers using a low-level language have more control over a computation and can, in principle, produce more efficient code. Unfortunately, lower-level programs are harder to write and worse, less portable, and these are more prone to errors and harder to maintain. Optimizing compilers include techniques to improve the performance of generated code, thus offsetting the inefficiency introduced by the high-level abstractions. The rapid evolution of computer architectures has also led to an insatiable demand for new compiler technology. Almost all high-performance systems take advantage of the same two basic techniques, parallelism and memory hierarchies. Parallelism can be found at several levels. At the instruction level, where multiple operations are executed simultaneously, and at the processor level, where different threads of the same application are run on different processors. Memory hierarchies are a response to the basic limitation that we can build a very fast storage or a very large storage, but not storage that is both fast and large. All modern microprocessors exploit instruction level parallelism. However, this parallelism can be hidden from the programmer. Programmers are written as if all instructions were executed in sequence. The hardware dynamically checks for dependencies in the sequential instruction stream and issues them in parallel when possible. In some cases, the machine includes a hardware scheduler that can change the instruction ordering to increase the parallelism in the program. Whether the hardware reorders the instructions or not, but compilers can rearrange the instructions to make instruction level parallelism more effective. Instruction level parallelism can also appear explicitly in the instruction set. Very long instruction word machines have instructions that can issue multiple operations in parallel. The Intel IA64 is a well-known example of such an architecture. All high-performance general-purpose microprocessors also include instructions that can operate on a vector of a data at the same time. Compiler techniques have been developed to generate a code automatically for such machines from sequential programs. A memory hierarchy consists of several levels of storage with different speeds and sizes. With the level closest to the processor being the fastest but smallest. The average memory access time of a program is reduced if most of its accesses are satisfied by the faster levels of the hierarchy. Both the parallelism and the existence of a memory hierarchy improve the potential performance of a machine. But they must be harnessed effectively by the compiler to deliver real performance on an application. Memory hierarchies are found in all machines. A processor usually has a small number of registers consisting of hundreds of bytes. Several levels of caches containing kilobytes to megabytes, physical memory containing megabytes to gigabytes, and finally secondary storage that contains gigabytes and beyond. Correspondingly, the speed of accesses between adjacent levels of the hierarchy can differ by two or three orders of magnitude. The performance of a system is often limited not by the speed of the processor, but by the performance of the memory subsystem. While compilers traditionally focus on optimizing the processor execution, more emphasis is now placed on making the memory hierarchy more effective. In the early days of computer architecture design, compilers were developed after the machines were built. That has changed. Since programming in high-level languages is the norm, the performance of a computer system is determined not by its raw speed, but also by how well compilers can exploit its features. Thus, in modern computer architecture development, compilers are developed in the processor design stage, and compiled code running on simulators is used to evaluate the proposed architectural features. One of the best known examples of how compilers influenced the design of computer architecture was the invention of the RISC, that is the reduced instruction set computer architecture. Prior to this invention, the trend was to develop progressively complex instruction sets intended to make assembly programming easier. These architectures were known as CISC, that is Complex Instruction Set Computer. For example, CISC instruction sets include complex memory addressing modes to support data structure accesses and procedure invocation instructions that save registers and pass parameters on the stack. Compiler optimizations often can reduce these instructions to a small number of simpler operations by eliminating the redundancies across complex instructions. Thus, it is desirable to build simple instruction sets. Compilers can use them effectively, and the hardware is much easier to optimize. Over the last three decades, many architectural concepts have been proposed. They include data flow machines, vector machines, VLIW, very long instruction word machines, SIMD, single instruction multiple data, SIMD arrays of processors, systolic arrays, multiprocessors with shared memory, and multiprocessors with distributed memory. The development of each of these architectural concepts was accompanied by the research and development of corresponding compiler technology. Some of these ideas have made their way into the designs of embedded machines. Since entire systems can fit on a single chip, the processors need no longer be prepackaged commodity units, but can be tailored to achieve better cost effectiveness for a particular application. While we normally think of compiling as a translation from a high-level language to the machine level, the same technology can be applied to translate between different kinds of languages. Let us see some of the important applications of program translation techniques. Compiler technology can be used to translate the binary code for one machine to that of another, following a machine to run programs originally compiled for another instruction set. Binary translation technology has been used by various computer companies to increase the availability of software for their machines. Not only most softwares are written in high-level languages, even hardware designs are mostly described in high-level hardware description languages like Verilog and VHDL. Hardware designs are typically described at the register transfer level, where variables represent registers and expressions represent combinational logic. Hardware synthesis tools translate register transfer level descriptions automatically into gates, which are then mapped to transistors and eventually to a physical layout. Unlike compilers for programming languages, these tools often take hours optimizing the circuit. Techniques to translate designs at higher levels, such as the behavior or functional level, also exist. Besides specifying software and hardware, languages are useful in many other applications. For example, Query languages, especially SQL, that is a structured query language, are used to search databases. Database queries consist of predicates containing relational and Boolean operators. They can be interpreted or compiled into commands to search a database for records satisfying that predicate. Simulation is a general technique used in many scientific and engineering disciplines to understand a phenomenon or to validate a design. Inputs to a simulator usually include the description of the design and specific input parameters for that particular simulation run. Simulations can be very expensive. We can typically need to simulate many possible design alternatives on many different input sets, and each experiment may take days to complete on a high performance machine. Instead of writing a simulator that interprets the design, it is faster to compile the design to produce a machine code that simulates that particular design natively. Compiled simulation can run orders of magnitude faster than an interpreter-based approach. Compiled simulation is used in many state-of-the-art tools that simulates designs written in Verilog and VHDL. Programs are arguably the most complicated engineering artifacts ever produced. They consist of many details, like every one of which must be correct before the program will work completely. As a result, errors are rampant in programs. Errors may crash a system, produce wrong results, render a system vulnerable to the security attacks, or even lead to catastrophic failures in critical systems. Testing is the primary technique for locating errors in programs. An interesting and promising complementary approach is to use data flow analysis to locate errors statically. Data flow analysis can find errors along all the possible execution paths, and not just those exercised by the input data sets, as in the case of program testing. Many of the data flow analysis techniques originally developed for compiler optimizations can be used to create tools that assist programmers in their software engineering tasks. Type checking is an effective and well-established technique to catch inconsistencies in the programs. It can be used to catch errors, for example, where an operation is applied to the wrong type of object, or if the parameters passed to a procedure do not match the signature of the procedure. Program analysis can go beyond finding type errors by analyzing the flow of a data through a program. For example, if a pointer is assigned null and then immediately it is dereferenced, the program is clearly in error. It is easier to make mistakes when programming in a lower level language than higher level one. For example, many security breaches in systems are caused by buffer overflows in programs written in C, because C does not have array bound checks. It is up to the user to ensure that the arrays are not accessed out of bounds. Failing to check that the data supplied by the user can overflow a buffer, the program may be tricked into storing a user data outside the buffer. An attacker can manipulate the input data that causes the program to misbehave and compromise the security of the system. Techniques have been developed to find buffer overflows in programs, but with limited success. Garbage collection is another excellent example of the trade-off between efficiency and a combination of ease of programming and software reliability. Automatic memory management obliterates all memory management errors, which are a major source of problems in C and C++ programs. Various tools have been developed to help programmers find memory management errors.